Nothing. How are you doing?
I hope you have your makeup to speak. But just in case.
Thank you.
You know, you look nice. I mean, nice view. It'll be a nice spot for a new settlement.
Systems are eager to absorb new data. I find this traveling agrees with me.
Well, then let's get moving.
You have been standing on a ledge all your life and you just didn't know it. When are
this
you
way,
going
pal.
To jump to your next existence? Are you going to jump now? Or do you need a push? I am now pushing you. You can thank me later.
Good dog.
Hey, boy.
What are you looking at? Never seen hard work before?
So full of yourself.
Excuse me. Hi.
That's close enough, stranger. We're a peaceful farm. We don't want any trouble.
It's okay. I'm friendly. Not looking to cause any trouble.
If you say so, but be warned, we're armed here. Set up. Don't try anything. Let me tell you. Farming ain't easy. Out in the field all day, every day? And every minute of it, spent watching your back.
What kind of crops do you grow here?
Mostly potatoes so far, but we're starting on melons. Blake Abernathy, you new to the Commonwealth?
Yes. And no. It's a long story.
Either way, good to see a new face. How about you? Ever think about working the land?
I'll probably give it a try someday.
Well, good luck to you then. Maybe I'll see you at the Diamond City Market someday and we'll do a swap. Word of advice though, if you do start up a farm, be ready to deal with the raiders. Why do all the hard work when you can just take what you want at gunpoint?
Can't you do something to protect yourself?
Last time those raiders hit us, my daughter Mary tried to stand up to them. Now she's buried out back of the house. Only 21 years old, and they shot her down without a thought. That's why we need the Minutemen back. And the sooner, the better.
There's nothing worse than losing a child. Believe me, I know.
All too well, I'm afraid. My sympathies are with you both.
I'm sorry to hear you say so. I don't have much to offer, but those raiders that killed Mary, they took her locket too. It's been in Connie's family for generations. If you could get it back, it'd mean a lot to us.
I'll see what I can do.
Good. Connie feels like it's a part of Mary. I don't think she'll rest easy again as long as it's gone.
You staying out of trouble? Let's move out. Anything you want to talk about?
Are all humans as formidable as you? If so, change some of my theories.
No. Nice.
It appears he was correct.
I'm fine. I'm glad that's over with.
something?
I'm not saying. Yes. Bingo.
It is hard to determine whether the surface is more or less susceptible to outbreaks, but a preparation plan is never a bad idea.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Everything okay, boy?
Are you sure there isn't someone more suited to all this?
Is something wrong, Cotsworth? Sweet. Good dog. I'll just take this. My pleasure. Huzzah! Glad that's over.
We are ready to shut off our mortal coeds. We cannot limit ourselves this action through skip, dance, or song. We must depart the way we live.
Sweet.
Depressed and alone. The end is nigh, and I am the raven. Follow the sounds of my flapping wings, for inaction is always a futile gesture.
Hell yeah. Nice. Hey, boy. I'm in.
Oh, you're on the terminal again.
Yes. And I'll just take this.
I believe a sniper has found us. That is the right word, yes?
To shreds!
Let's get on with it.
This is so violent.
Hey, boy. Nice. Tight. Hell yeah.
Natasha, pick anything good?
Maybe. Sweet. Mine now.
Enemy detected.
Thanks for your help. Just come to Mama. I'm sorry. I guess I just lost control. Everything okay, boy? Yes. Hey, boy. Yes.
Your hands after that. It can be unsanitary to handle your deceased. I'll be fine. Are these cultists truly human now? Beyond that point.
That sounds ridiculous. Excellent. Dog meat. Hey, boy. Drop me. Hey, boy. How you doing, buddy? Any words of wisdom?
Do you require something?
No, not really. How you doing, buddy? Hey, boy. Think you can find something for me? See if there's any good stuff nearby, boy. Thank you. Hey, sweetie.
Something you need? If you're not a customer, you're trouble. So what'll it be?
You out here all by yourself?
Hardly. Gus looks out for me. So don't get any ideas. Now, are you buying or not?
Maybe later.
What? Don't trust a kid trader? Jeez, lady.
Hey, pal.
Are you buying? Or just in the way?
Let's see what you have.
Ha, now you're talking.
Analysis, Green. Standing down.
All right.
Do not interfere with security operations.
Hey, boy. Dog meat. Hey, boy. Hey, boy. Get him, boy.
Nice.
Radiation, Mom!
you hear something?
I'm not sure. Let's do this. Come to Mama. Hey, Codsworth.
Yes?
Never mind. I'll just take this. There's a good dog. Get on with it, then.
Sorry, just doing my job.
I guess you could say that.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies.
How's it going?
Great green jewel. Diamond City is a place where everyone knows everyone, and no one talks to anyone.
That's impossible.
Ugh! You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. You want into Diamond City, right?
Just traveling through.
What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right.
Curie.
Give me a personal pipe. Give me a minute.
Better head.
quick before our band catches on the bluff.
This place, Diamond City. What is it?
Oh, the Green Jewel? She's a sight. Everyone who's anyone in the Commonwealth is from here, settled here, got kicked out of here. A big wall, some power, working plumbing, schools, and some security goons are what make Diamond City the big monster it is. Oh, love it or hate it. You'll see for yourself soon enough. Let's go.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrapped for parts.
Mr. McDonough, tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
Newspapers just like to stir up trouble.
A fair point, Mum. But I believe it depends on the reporter. Exposing the truth is one thing. Twisting it is another.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, miss. No, no, no. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great Green Jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
What are you two arguing about anyway?
What do you think? Print lies and everybody's happy, but if you print the truth...
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
My baby boy, Sean. He's less than a year old.
Wait, your son's missing? You hear that, McDonough? Is Diamond City Security just gonna stand by while a mother searches for her infant son all on her own?
No, don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
A mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there is one private citizen, Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. Now, I have to get going. I'm sorry, Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates him?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story.
Baseball game? How exciting!
You're starting to worry me. Hey, sweetie.
Public is here. Hey, kiddo. Pull the wool out from under your
eyes. Paper sales.
What do you mean by that?
Well, anyone is one of those things.
That motor is
that secretary of his. Her.
I've been saying that for weeks.
Hair.
You got a robot butler?
Too bad.
I cut her hair myself, and I know human hair.
That's just it, Johnny. You wouldn't be able to tell the difference. If you nicked McDonough with your razor, he'd bleed. Don't mean nothing.
Hey, buddy.
Oh, wow. You're tall.
What makes you think that?
He knows a guy that works for him. They got a code phrase and everything. Follow the freedom trail. What
the hell is that supposed to mean? You're full of it. That kind of talk is going to get you stabbed.
What have you been up to?
I could use one of those robots.
As could every household.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, Miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
Do you have any idea how I could find him?
He disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
You said Malone's from Good Neighbor?
Yeah, it's a tough neighborhood. Northeast a ways. People with power there care about two things. Style and body count.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
Ellie.
Be careful down in that subway. Who knows what could be living there now?
Thanks for the advice.
Don't move, Synth. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
Hey.
I swear, I'm not a Synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Thanks for the advice.
Put the gun down, now!
He's a Synth! He'll kill us all!
Kyle, no!
Okay, show's over. There are no Synths in Diamond City, hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
Hey.
He pulled a gun on me. My own brother.
You're safe now. That's all that matters.
I'm not a synth. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me? I need a minute.
What's everyone still standing around for? Go back to your own damn business.
Do you have a moment?
You read the paper. Damn synths. Hiding among us.
Really?
It's remarkable the things you can do with only two hands.
Yep. How are you doing?
I have not yet mastered Dr. Venturi's advanced steam pack recipe, but I am working on it.
That's good to know. Hey, Codsworth.
There you go.
Officer.
Believe you eat that food. Only one thing worth buying in a dugout inn, and that's the booze.
Man's gotta eat. What can I say?
A real Diamond City boy eats at the noodle stand.
When out comes the most dangerous of all sea monsters, a Meyerlurk!
A Meyerlurk? Come on!
That's like 2 out of 10 points of danger tops. Now, if you want to talk something really good.
Redeem!
I forgot you were there, Yefim. What is it?
How are you doing?
You know what? Never mind. I'll handle it myself.
See this bar? I killed a man for it. No, I kid. He is dead, though. Now, let me know when you're ready to order.
So, this your bar?
Damn straight it is. My brother Yefim and I make the best moonshine in the entire Commonwealth. We call it Bobrov's Best. Had to start renting out rooms just so customers had a place to safely pass out after drinking.
Sure. Let's take a look.
That's what I like to hear.
That's good to know.
Oh, a customer. Need a room?
Hey, Yefim.
Glad we haven't scared you off yet. Need a room?
All right. Here's your money.
You're in room 2, just through the door.